Hi, everybody. Happy Wednesday. This is Q&A on its new day, questions and Ayurvedic answers. And it's beautiful outside and it's definitely summertime. So I hope everyone is drinking lots of water and taking care of themselves. This in, you know, in Ayurvedic terms, it's Pitta time. And Pitta time is heating, really hot. So, you know, like the sun is out, the sun is high. Hey, Brandon. So summertime, this is Pitta time. Pitta is also known as our digestion and our fire. So if you're eating a lot of spicy foods right now, if you're taking a lot of heating, super hot drinks, time to cool it down a little bit. Doesn't mean head to the ice and ice water. And if that's something that you need, go for it. But just cool your body down. Use more cooling spices like coriander. You know, my trifecta that I always go to is coriander, fennel, and cumin. Cumin is more heating out of all of those. But still, that trifecta is a beautiful balance of herbs and spices to use in your cooking. So if you are adding things like garlic powder, onion powder, cayenne pepper to a lot of your cooking, just cool it down a little bit. Summertime, cool it down. So I'm really excited and I'm kind of nervous. Today's topic, letting your shadows be heard. And when I refer to shadows, I'm talking about those voices in your head. I'm talking about those dark, people, things, energies that talk to you. My new coach, Tara Butler, she refers to them as saboteurs. So really those negative things that you tell yourself all the time that come up throughout the day, that come up while you're eating popcorn at the movie theater and you're like taking handfuls because you really like it, and that voice pops up and is like, maybe you should eat one kernel at a time because that's what you should be doing. That's just a personal example. I don't know if anyone goes through that ever with popcorn at the movie theater. But that is a definite saboteur that comes up when I'm talking to myself in this weird situation. And these are situations when that voice says, you need to. Hi. You need to do something. You wish that you could have done something. I want to be doing something. I need to be doing something different. Those are the times when you really want to pay attention. When that voice, that very first sentence, that very first few words that come up and it's like the I need, the I want, right there, that's telling you that someone else is speaking. Someone else is doing the talking. And it might not be your true higher self, your true self. So really start to pay attention, and I've talked about this before, to the words that you're using with yourself. Really important, the language we use to speak about ourselves and to the words we use with our friends and our family is so very important. So, you know, this is Q&A. This is a time for me to converse with you. So if you have a voice in your head, or you're dealing with something like this, or even today you had something come up for you, just type it in. The way Facebook Live and Instagram Live works is I can read what you're writing. You can't really talk to me, so it limits a specific conversation that we could be having, but I think that this is a great platform for just reaching out to you. And that is why I come on. It used to be every week. I took a few weeks off to kind of reposition myself and think about how I wanted to take Q&A forward. And this is it. Every Wednesday at noon, I get on starting with the topic and then move into some questions that you guys might have with Ayurvedic answers, because I'm an Ayurvedic practitioner and I love it. And I'm here to help you and answer questions about your mind, body, spirit. And when I say spirit, it could be anything for you. It can be a higher power. It can be your higher self. It can be the universe and the energies that we surround ourselves with. And today's topic again is letting your shadows be heard. So I just want to dive into that a little bit deeper. if you are ignoring the voices, if you push them to the side, if you send them off to deal with another day, it's going to keep talking to you. It's going to keep bringing it up, whatever that voice is, whatever that need or want is. So just like if you have a computer virus and you don't actually get to the root of the problem, that computer virus is just going to keep popping up. It's not going to go away. You can push exit and deal with it later, but it's going to come back. So the real work here is honoring that shadow voice, honoring that saboteur voice, honoring that voice that doesn't serve you, and not just pushing it to the side. Because I have talked about that, and I think in my past thinking it has been, you know, don't listen to that voice, push for positivity. But I am learning, I'm always learning, that we need to actually listen to that voice. If you are something that I am really dealing with is smoking weed. You know, it's totally legal here in Portland, and I've smoked for a long time. I'm not a heavy smoker, but I do enjoy it. But there's always this voice inside of me that's like, girl, get it out. You don't use it. It's ruining everything. But when I do use it, I enjoy it, and I enjoy relaxing, and I enjoy that process. So if I just listen to, you know, so there's two voices here. There's one, I mean, there's many voices, don't get me wrong, and I know you know what I'm talking about, with not just smoking weed, but a lot of different circumstances. But, you know, there's the one that's like, don't do it. You know, it's horrible. You're addicted. You can't move away. Like, just stop everything. It's not good for you. It's not good for your kidneys. It creates extra heat in your body. And there's the other voice that's like, chill, it's good. If that's what you want, go for it. You don't overuse. You are able to continue through your life. You are starting your own business. Like, take a chill day. If I don't honor both of those voices, I've got a cute little bird right here. If I don't honor both of those voices, I am never going to allow them to silence and follow my true self. You know, we really have to, again, honor both. I turn to this voice of, don't stop, you're addicted. Stop, you're addicted. You can't take this anymore. You shouldn't be doing this. I turn to that voice and I say, thank you. I honor you for explaining to me or wanting me to be cautious of the steps that I take when I smoke. Great, I honor you, thank you so much. And then I turn to the other voice, the voice of like, just fucking do it, you know? And I say, thank you for allowing me to relax. Thank you. And now I can proceed through that moment. I can proceed and really think about that moment of, is this a time where I want to smoke or not smoke? Is this a time where I want to eat something sweet or not eat something sweet? Is this a time where I want to take that extra nap because I know that I need it, or go out and hang with my friends? You know, these voices come up in so many spots and spaces, and it's really, really beneficial for us to really hear what they're trying to say, how they're helping, and then move from that space. So my friend Brandon just wrote in, let's see, why aren't you letting me roll? So I can't read the very beginning, but something about you just started thinking about this or wanting to write a book, and then the day after you thought of the idea, your work slowed down to nothing for the first time in a year, and you felt like the reason you slowed down was the universe telling you to go sit down and write. Totally. You have no work to do. Yep. Great. So beautiful. I mean, the voices that we are hearing, the voices that we listen to, you know, they're there for a reason. And I really want us to pay attention to the lesson they're trying to teach us, honor what they're saying, and then move in the space and the direction that you believe is true for you after listening to all sides. It's like you always have your pack, you always have your inner friends with you. And listening to them. And they all come in, you know, archetypes. There's the judge. There's the cool guy. There's the mom. There's the sassy aunt that thinks she knows everything. Really just hear those voices and write them down. Again, my coach, Tara Butler, she has a beautiful exercise where we write them down. And I think just like if you have ever taken a food log, you've written the foods down, you've looked back to them, you know, look back to what you've written down, see if you've made changes, see if you've taken steps towards what you truly want. And I'm going to talk about ego in just a second, because that is a huge part of the voices that we listen to. And I have a friend, Summer Ann, who wrote in, "There's always a time to smoke." Yes, girl. Again, if you take smoking liberally for yourself, there is a time and there is a space to do that. If you're dealing with things like I have been dealing with that voice that's like, you can't, you shouldn't, you need to, there's a time to listen to that too. Thank you, Summer. And thanks, Brandon, for writing in. I love when you guys do that. This is such a conversation. If you write something in, I will read it out loud. So if you feel that there's something a little more personal that you want to talk about or open up a conversation with, feel free to direct message me and we can continue that conversation. So I really want to kind of get into a little bit of the ego and how that plays a part into the voices that we hear. And the ego is such a manifestation of our lives here on this earth, in our bodies. We are born beautiful and pure, and society gives us this ego, and we take it on, we step into the body that has an ego. So how do we separate that, and how do we work through that? And honestly, you know, this is a lifelong journey. So if this is your first time that you're hearing the word ego and that you have one, let me clarify, this isn't like your ego of like, this is me and this is who I am at a party and I can't, like, this is who I show people. You know, your ego is a little bit, it goes a little bit deeper, and it goes to the patterns and the routines and the rituals that you keep, and how, you know, opposite your ego is your spirit. And again, your spirit is your higher self, a higher vision of yourself, a higher purpose, the energy of the universe. These are the opposite. And so when we relate the ego back to these shadow sides, we really want to see where that ego is starting to kind of touch down, where that ego is pushing its way through. And then on the flip side, the true self, what you truly want, how are you allowing that to come in? So it relates just directly back to what we spoke about, which was listening to all sides and then finding your true path. That is the answer. And how you do that, you know, I talk a lot about meditation. I will never not talk about meditation. That is one huge way that you start to build a relationship with yourself, because it's not so easy. Hi, everyone who's joining. It's not so easy to hear and know that a shadow voice is talking unless you're doing work to listen. So meditation, the meditation that I do, which is a transcendental heart-based meditation where I do, you know, silence myself and I'm sitting for 20 minutes. That's not the only meditation that you have at your fingertips. But this one really allows me to connect into my subconscious, to connect into what it is that I really want, that I really need. And it's not an external egocentric voice that's telling me. That is the key. What is it that you want? What is it that you need? And what is coming from the heart? You know, we have our brain, we have the neurons, we have our pathways that have been connected and the patterns that have been created throughout our entire life. Now, did you know we also have neurons in the stomach and neurons in the heart? So we really have three brains that are, I refer to them as these three brains that are really working us towards our future of enlightenment. And enlightenment is really just baby steps towards understanding yourself and finding your true higher self, your higher power. Again, this is a conversation. I know that when I come on live, it's really me talking to you, but this is a conversation. I promise. Type in the box. Do you have shadows? Do you have these voices that go on in your head and you don't want to call them voices? Do you have other thoughts that continually push you and direct you? When I referred to meditation, meditation for me allows myself to shorten the time that I realize there is something someone else talking. In my past, you know, I might have said, oh, I really need to do this, or someone's telling me, you really need to do this, you need to stop, you need to go do this XYZ. I now hear those voices much more quickly, and I respond to them much more quickly. I really feel that I'm able to hear the subtle messages that my body is asking of me and take the time to think, is this me? Is this truly what I want? So this has been a great little talk and conversation. This Q&A, questions and Ayurvedic answers, happens every new day, Wednesday at noon. Bring your questions. I will come with a topic, but I love when people bring questions about their health, both mind, body, and spirit. When you're working this trifecta, you are able to heal. You are able to continue the harmonious balance of health and your busy life and the work that you do and the life that you want to live. So again, come with your questions. If it's not a question and it's a comment, come with your comments. I like it all. This time is for you, and I hope to see you next week. Okay, bye.